Hello everyone, this is another of our Physics 201 Kinematics YouTube video lecture. So today we are going to look at kinematics in two dimensions, specifically projectile motion as a type of uniform accelerated motion. And this video is going to be only about how to correctly draw a vector diagram in order to be able to solve problems that involve kinematics in two dimensions. So there we go, we have an object over here, this black dot that is being launched at an angle theta with an initial velocity V naught, angle theta with respect to the x-axis. As it's being launched at an angle theta, the trajectory of this projectile is going to be parabolic. Is going to go in this parabolic path, and at some point over here it will reach its maximum height. So it's going to go up, reach the apex, and then come down. So long as the object is being launched and it lands at the same level, we know that time up is going to be equal to time down. It's going to be equal to time down. Therefore, the hang time is going to be twice time up or twice time down. So let's go ahead and draw the vectors, the three important vector quantities in a kinematics problem, which are velocity, acceleration, and displacement. So we are going to consider, because of the symmetry of this problem, we are only going to consider two points rather than all three. We are going to consider the beginning of the motion, the apex, and then should we need to consider any kind of quantities in the second part of motion, knowing that this is a symmetric situation, then everything is going to be very similar in the motion down as it was in the motion up, except for, of course, the direction of the motion. So if you remember from my PowerPoint slide, when we look at kinematics in two dimensions, we have to consider separately x motion and y motion. So we need to look at every one of the quantities involved, which are again velocity, displacement, and acceleration, with respect to x and y components. So at the very beginning, let's call that point A. The object is being launched at point A with initial velocity V naught. Well, V naught is neither horizontal nor vertical, so therefore, in order to have our x and y quantities, we are going to have to resolve it. How do we resolve a vector? Well, exactly as we learned in trigonometry, we are going to draw from the arrow of V naught perpendicular to the x-axis. We're going to get this component here, and we are going to draw perpendicular to the y-axis over here, perpendicular. So we're going to go get this other component here. So we have an x component, which will be V naught cosine theta, as you can see in this right triangle, if you remember your sines and cosines, hopefully you do. And this one over here on the y is going to be the same in magnitude as this one, which tells me that it will have to be a V naught sine theta. So we have the x and y components for velocity at the beginning. Then, as the object moves towards the apex, the vertical velocity will decrease because we have one acceleration only, and that's going to be the acceleration due to gravity. You can draw it anywhere you want in the diagram. It's the same, vertically down, little g, and because it's vertical, only the vertical component of the velocity will change. And because it's vertically down and the object, when it moves towards the apex, it's moving upward, the vertically down acceleration will decrease the vertical velocity from V naught sine theta to a smaller one, smaller one, smaller one, smaller one, until at the apex, we will not have a vertical velocity. So at apex, vertical velocity is zero. However, the horizontal velocity, because there is no horizontal acceleration, the horizontal velocity will be the same every single place. So the same V naught cosine theta we had here, we are going to have at the apex as well. So whatever velocity we had here, we have to make sure we draw the exact same velocity there. Again, the exact same magnitude, V naught cosine theta. No matter where you look at the velocity, horizontally, it will have to be the same. Again, that is because the only acceleration we have in projectile motion is vertical, which means it's not going to affect the horizontal component of the velocity. So now we have velocity in terms of x and y, nothing here in terms of y, at the two important points, we have the acceleration. So the only thing that's missing is displacement. So let's go ahead and remember what is displacement. Well, displacement is the vector that connects one point to another. In this case, the beginning with the apex here. Let's draw that in purple here. And as we can see, this displacement is neither horizontal nor vertical, so we'll have to do the same thing with the displacement as we did with the velocity. We are going to have to resolve it. So very carefully from the arrow of this displacement, let's label that D, we'll draw perpendicular to the x-axis, perpendicular, which makes now this over here, the horizontal component of the displacement. We'll name it something in a minute, and then we'll draw perpendicular to the y component, to the y-axis here, perpendicular, which means again that's a right angle. So therefore we are going to have a vertical component of the displacement. We're going to come back to it and label it in a minute. So now, vertically, if you look at this component, it's going to be the maximum height that the projectile can reach. So therefore, this part over here, again, remember this is a right angle, this part over here is going to be the same as that one, and that makes it the maximum height. So now I'm going to label it H max, and this part over here is actually half of the horizontal displacement that the object would have. While the horizontal displacement of a projectile is called the range, so that will be from here all the way here. But because we only go half of it, that's going to become our range over 2. So the two components of the displacement vector are going to be r over 2 and h max. So now we have all three vector quantities, velocity, displacement, and acceleration on our vector diagram. Once again, they have to be either horizontal or vertical, and if they are not, we need to resolve them. So we had to resolve V naught because it wasn't horizontal or vertical, and we got the V naught cosine theta and V naught sine theta components, and we had to resolve the displacement vector to get half of the range here, r over 2 horizontally and h max vertically. At apex, we only have one velocity, and that's horizontal. There is no vertical velocity here. We can even write that down as a reminder. At apex, Vy equals 0. And the acceleration that we have, it's the acceleration due to gravity vertically down. So the next thing that you would do when you would apply all these concepts in a problem solving, you would pick a positive direction, but it wouldn't be only in one dimension, it would have to be in two dimensions. So I have a rule of thumb, as I told you in my previous YouTube lectures, I look at all my vectors and I choose my positive direction in the direction that most of them go. So let's look at them horizontally. I have r over 2 going to the right, and I have v naught cosine theta going to the right as well. That means I'm going to pick to the right to be my horizontal positive direction. Vertically, I have h max going up, v naught sine theta going up, and g going down. Out of three vertical vectors, two go up, so according to my rule of thumb, I'm going to pick up for my positive vertical direction. And now we are ready to use this kind of a diagram for solving problems, which is going to be the topic of the next YouTube video. Thank you.